Before we get out of here, the Memphis Tigers at Tulsa, late game, 9 p.m. Eastern time on ESPN2. Tulsa, a 3-point favorite. This line opened at 4.5. And Chris, I'll tell you, my line on this was actually Memphis -2. So when it came out 6.5 points the other direction, I thought maybe I would need to go back and look at exactly what I'm focusing on as far as my numbers go. Memphis 5-1 straight up in their last six against Tulsa, but they are 1-9 straight up and 1-9 against the spread in their last 10 as a road underdog. But the betting trends don't exactly go the same for Tulsa. They are 2-8 against the spread. Their last 10 as a home favorite, and they have not covered this year in that role. They got absolutely smoked by Houston last week. I mean, it was not even a ball game. And Memphis got beat on the road at Temple. This seems like a decent buy low spot for Memphis. I don't think they are as bad as they looked in getting beat by Temple, because that was a very close ball game. I'm going to roll with the Tigers plus the three here. I feel this team has playmakers. Tulsa, I think, is trying to find itself right now. I think this is a bad spot on the schedule for Tulsa to have to play Memphis.
All right, so finally, we're going to get a disagreement, and I'm so glad you put this game on here. And I'm going to tell you why. Because I put a lot of faith in Memphis Tigers going up to Pittsburgh, to Philadelphia, and being able to be a bad Temple team. And they got beat straight up. This is a dead-ass football team. Ryan Silverfield, they shouldn't have brought their asses back to Memphis. I hope they went straight from Philadelphia to Tulsa. Don't even come back here. Don't eat our food. Don't drink our water. Don't sleep in our bed. Keep your ass out there until you come back with a win. That's a damn shame. They better come back after beating Tulsa. They better beat Tulsa this weekend. Give me Tulsa. I ain't bet on this damn team. They're a bunch of punks, man. That pissed me off. Well, look, how bad of a football team is Temple, Gary? How bad is a football team is Temple? How far are they from Vanderbilt?
That has never mattered. Memphis has literally never covered against the spread against Temple.
Ever. That's fine. Going up there and not covering is fine because they're usually a pretty heavy favorite. They were laying 11 this time. It's fine. Don't cover. That's fine. You lose, and you lose handily. They were never in that game. They never led in that game. At any point in time, did they ever have a chance to win that football game? They got their ass whipped by a terrible football team.
Hold on, I got to go find this now. They led in that game. They actually had a shot to win in the second half.
In the second half, my ass.
No. Hold on.
Now you're gonna pick nits about something when you know they played like shit and they didn't deserve to be in that football game. They weren't in that football game.
No, they were not in the football game. You're 100% correct. They deserved to lose because they played very poorly. I'm with you on that. But saying that they never led, that they never, you know, they did. I mean, it was a 34-31 game, and I just
they were up 3-0 at one point in time.
That's what I'm pulling up right now. Let's see, scoring plays. They were up 3-0.
Oh, my God.
No, they were up 17-0.
17. They were up 17-0. They lost that game.
And then they were in the third quarter. They were up 23-17. So.
Trash-ass team. This is a trash-ass team. Ryan Silverfield should be ashamed. He should be ashamed of himself. Don't come back here. Don't eat my food. Don't you put a piece of barbecue in your mouth. Don't you eat that fried chicken. That's my shit.
Don't you love college football, man? You can go from one week being the G5 team that beat Mississippi State the week after they beat NC State, and then turn around 2 weeks later and go up to Philadelphia and play against a trash Temple team and lose that game.
Well, don't help that you let UTSA come in here and whoop your butt too.
No, you're probably
you're up 21-0 against them, and you don't score again the next three quarters, and they just roll off 28 points like it's just water off a duck's ass.
Yeah. No, you're right about that. You are correct. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, @GaryWCE, @ChrisBGiannini, @WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.